Hello to you all that are watching this channel. Thank you for choosing to watch this video. This is the making of the space station project. If you want to see the geometry notes, make sure to check the link in the top right corner that appearing during this demo, or the one in the description. This video will focus on the materials, and we have kind of a cool setup for the background, the world shader. We have the stars and the galaxies in the background, and the one for the space station and all the other stuff. So this is what we are going to look at. But before that, I want to thank you all for supporting this channel. I want to thank to all those that are purchasing the project files like this one from the Gumroad. This is really helping me to go on. And I also want to thank you to all of you that are supporting this channel by subscribing, liking the videos, commenting on them. This is also much appreciated. So thank you all of you for doing that. Now let's get started and let's see how the material of this space station was constructed. We have quite a few elements. These light streaks from here, these were done in the geometry notes, and they are a simple material, just an emission shader, but everything else is done in the shader for this station. If we look, this is just plain geometry, but when we go to the render view, we see a lot of details. So what's going on? Okay, let's look at this. I'm gonna do a full screen so you can take a screen grab for this, and then I'm gonna explain you what's going on. So we have all of this and the output. Everything is nicely labeled, but I'm gonna go through everything anyway. So we have this custom UV map that was created in geometry nodes. I explained about that in that video. And that is the driver for everything that we see here. So let's look at the surface detail, this cell-like structure. This is passed through this displacement node in these settings. And it's the result of this Voronoi texture that it's looking like this, if we look at it straightly. And this is the base for everything else that we did here. So let's look at the static light rectangles, the one that we see here. This one with white. So in order to create this, I took this noise texture that you see here. And doesn't look like anything special, but it's very important because we have this result. So by using a color ramp, I crush the values from this Voronoi texture. And then I use this to isolate the effects. So this noise texture pass through this color ramp, give us this result. And by mixing these two, basically this one from here with the black color and using this as a mask, so to only show in the white parts, we get this result from here, splotches of white lights. So using this and mixing it with a emission shader, we get this result that we see here, the one with these lights here. And this setup that you see here, canceling the lights, is just mixing the black color with this shader, and then by using this setup, taking the frame and doing a divider for speed and a ping pong to get going back and forth from 0 to 1, we switch from having lights on and to having the lights off. And this is how the rectangular lights were accomplished. We also have this lines that you see here. So if I go to, let's see another frame, maybe to 450, we can see that these are also fading in and out. And the way to I get got those, again, I took this basic texture and I pass it through a color ramp and I got these results. And then I took this Voronoi texture that is giving me, basically passing it through this color ramp that it's crushed all the way to the end, as you can see. If I make this one a little bit larger, you can see that it's almost on top of the white part. The white part is at zero, and the next part it's at this very, very small value. And this is giving us these tricks you see here. And again, I took these parts that you see here, and these parts that you see here, and then I pass it through a node that is set on multiply. So by multiplying, everything that has zero on it becomes zero. If we have zero here, or we have zero here, meaning wherever we keep the black from here, and we keep the black from here. So the result of this is just the common white from both parts. So basically, this Voronoi texture from here, it's helping us to create lines. And this one that is based on what we did here, it's masking these lines to only the edges of this texture. And again, I mixed this with everything, and I used the same trick. This mixing with the black value, the emission shader from here, and passing this but through this setup. Again, the frame, divider for speed with different value than here, and a ping pong 0 to 1 to put the lines on and off. And we get the result in the end from here, where we have these purple lights going on and off, and this light streak the same pulsing on and off. And for the beacons, we have also an interesting material. I'm gonna show you like this, so you can see what's going on. And now I'm gonna explain you what's going on with this part. So we have these beacons that they have the beacon light material, and this is kind of simple. It's just an emission shader that has a light pulsing by using this setup. The frame, the divider, then I use the random from the object info to add a little bit of variation to the pulsing speed by using this color ramp with values from 0.8 to 1. And multiplying by 120, so every 120 frames or less, we get the lights pulsing. And for the material of the base, we kind of have a lot of stuff going on here. So we have a metallic base with this color, similar to the space station. It's also a metallic shader at the base. And then by using the UV map from the geometry nodes, we do all this stuff. So we have these cells that you see here, that it's passing through the displacement and creating this surface detail that are visible, especially when we are in the light. So let's look at something that is more in the light. Something like this. It's giving us this the surface details. And then this golden color is done by using this layer weight with the facing value, pass through color ramp, and then used as a mask for this emission shader that we have here. So this is basically giving this light here that it's creating the illusion that these suns are actually throwing light on these surfaces. So that was the details for the cells. And then we had these edges that you see here that are also pulsing. And they are done by using kind of the same technique like the other way, taking the base texture, crushing it to get the lines, and then using this noise texture on the multiply to give us just part of the lights here. And this is what it's been done here. And in order to make those lights pulsing, again, a little bit of random variation for speed, but from 0.5 to 1, and this 120 value that is controlling the speed. And then this ping pong is taking care of putting this to 0 1 0 1 0 1, and then again we have this the same setup, black shader with this emission shader. So this is how we get the pulsing of the light. So that will be kind of all for this material. So now let's look at the world shader. This is also very interesting. So I'm gonna show you. This is the entire setup. And let's see what's going on. We have this HDRI image from Polyheaven. You can get the link in the description, that it's taking care of the light of this scene. And then using the light path with this camera array, we separate the light and diffraction from the background. So that's why we have the light from the this shader, but the background is constructed entirely in the geometry nodes. And for that, I added stars and galaxies. The stars are this noise texture that is passed through this color ramp, giving us this result that you see here. And then I multiplied it just to increase the strength. And for the galaxies, I took this mask wave texture and then pass it a little bit through a color ramp. And this is the shape of the galaxies. Then another mask wave texture that was passed through this color ramp to get these colors. And then I mixed this using this as a factor from here. So wherever we have white, we use this color ramp from here. And wherever we have black, we use this color that it's mostly black. And then these two mixed together gives us this result. And by using this add mix shader with the add mode, we could add the galaxies to the stars. And this factor is controlling the strength of the galaxies. So if I increase this, these become a lot brighter. But with this default, they are just a hint of the galaxies. So this is the color setup for this background with the strength of 2, and mixing it with the HDRI, we get also the light for this scene. Without that, we will get an entirely different result, as you can see here. This is adding to the reflection of the this metallic shader that is composing the star base. For the sun, like I said, there is just a simple emission shader, and this shader has this color. And when I duplicated it and pass it here and here, and it's important to have them be in contact with the shadow if you want this bloom that is coming from these settings: ambient occlusion, bloom with default settings, and screen space reflections. I also added a little bit of lights. This rim light, this one here, it's responsible for casting this light here. And this one is having this color that you see here. And then I used these three lights to add a little bit more depth to the scene by emphasizing the details. And those are just white lights with these values that you see here and here. And all of them have content shadows enabled. The camera, 35 millimeters, and I played with the depth field for the beginning and the end. And that's pretty much all there is to say about this project. Everything else is just details. So thank you very much for watching this video, and again, thank you very much for supporting this channel. I really appreciate your support. So hope you find this information useful in your project. Make sure to use it, and happy blending.